Sevilla has signed Arsenal's ex-mascot Gunnersaurus, who was fired the day before yesterday from the London club. And awesome and positive news awaits us. It seems that it's the main summer transfer. By the way, press like if you respect Sevilla for such a generous act. Why didn't Sancho move to Manchester United? Dembele is negotiating behind Barcelona's back. Ronaldo has problems with Mayorga again. A huge mess is taking its place in Barca, and journalists caught curious shots of Griezmann. Guys, we are doing our best for you, so subscribe now, please, if you're putting this off all the time. We'll be very pleased. Friends, write the main summer transfer in your opinion. We vote for Gunnersaurus, and you? Well, we are about to start. Let's go! Cavani took number 7 in Manchester United. It was previously owned by Alexis Sanchez. I was thinking about leaving football. I think I could devote myself to the life in the village, said Edinson Cavani after moving to Manchester United. Decision on the result of the Juventus vs Napoli match. Postponed. Real didn't buy anyone in the summer transfer window for the first time in 40 years. Liverpool and Bayern are ahead of Manchester United for Jadon Sancho. They are vying to buy him next summer. La Liga informed Atletico about Thomas Partey's departure 32 minutes before the window closed. Arsenal did notify the club. Martin Braithwaite takes number 9 shirt at Barcelona after Suarez left. Sancho's transfer would have cost Manchester United 250 million euros in terms of agency and salary, so the club left the deal. PSG presented the third kid for the current season. The goalkeeper of the national team of Ukraine and Real Madrid, Andrei Lunin, passed a positive test for coronavirus. All English Premier League clubs spent a combined £1.24 billion over the summer transfer window. Chelsea paid the most for the purchase of players, £226.1 million. I had 2 million messages on WhatsApp after playing against PSG. I was threatened with death. ESPN UK quotes Marseille defender Alvaro Gonzalez. Barcelona aims to sign Depay in January. Memphis has been notified of such a scenario. Luka Zidane leaves Real Madrid for Rayo Vallecano as a free agent. Eriksen refused a loan to Borussia and Hertha. Real Madrid have signed the 16-year-old Mallorca defender Obrador. He was interested in Barca. Saint-Étienne was unable to return Arsenal defender William Saliba due to administrative problems. The loan has been already agreed. Shaqiri has coronavirus. This is Liverpool's third COVID player now and the fourth one since September. I'm ready to reimburse Arsenal for the entire salary of Gunnersaurus while I'm the club player, Mesut Özil said. Officially, Liverpool and Porto have reached an agreement on the loan of midfielder Marco Grujic before the end of the season. Midfielder Sami Khedira was not included in Juventus' squad for the UEFA Champions League group stage. Bayern loaned 19-year-old Benfica midfielder Thiago Dantas. Götze joined PSV as a free agent. The contract is lasting for 2 years. On October 6, Barcelona and Lyon signed a deal on Depay, 5 million euros plus 10 million possible bonuses. La Liga has blocked the transition of the Dutch due to the salary cap being exceeded. Everton has loaned 30-year-old Roma goalkeeper Robin Olsen for one season. Sporting has loaned Inter midfielder Joao Mario until the season's end. 27-year-old West Ham's winger Felipe Anderson will be in Porto this season. The loan is valid until the end of the season. We continue to talk about the ambiguous situation of Ousmane Dembele in Barcelona. Two hot news caught our attention yesterday. According to us, Barcelona, represented by Koeman, notified Ousmane that he should consider the offer of Manchester United. The thing is that the new coach of Barca gives Dembele a very low range of expectations. He's below all the players in the attacking group in the rotation. Even Conrad de la Fuente from Barcelona B is higher than him. According to Catalunya Radio, Dembele snubbed Manchester United due to an offer from Juventus. Ousmane's agent has already held negotiations with Turin representatives. It is very likely that he will move to Serie A next summer or summer 2022, when Dembele's contract with Barca expires. The story of the relationship between Juventus striker Cristiano Ronaldo and American model Catherine Mayorga is not complete, writes The Sun. Catherine has filed a new lawsuit and intends to initiate a new case in the US court to receive compensation in damages for the alleged attack on her in a Las Vegas hotel room in the amount of £165,000. The documents went to the District Court of Nevada. By November 30, lawyers of both parties must meet to agree on a date for the hearing, tentatively in December. Ronaldo's legal team tried to appeal the acceptance of the documents for the second time, but the court refused and took time to do a thorough study. Previously, Ronaldo had been cleared of suspicion of rape. Barcelona has started to cut salaries again. According to Marca, all employees of the club, including the first team players, will have their salaries cut. Ronald Koeman and his coaching staff will also suffer. The main problem is that Barca wants to do this in the coming week, but most of the first team players have left for the national teams. Barcelona has big financial problems. At a recent convention of the club members, the management presented a financial report, according to which the Blaugranas has a debt of €488 million. The club ended last season with a loss of €97 million. We wonder how Messi and other Barcelona leaders will react this time. France national team head coach Didier Deschamps expressed his concern about Antoine Griezmann's situation at Barcelona. "I often talk to Griezmann. I'm sure that he is currently unhappy with the position at Barcelona. I don't want to interfere with the club issues of our players. Griezmann is currently playing on the right flank. We don't understand the fact why he is not playing in a more central position," Deschamps said. The coach of Barcelona, Ronald Koeman, is dissatisfied with the current form of Griezmann. After the match with Sevilla, the coach said, "In the match with Sevilla, Griezmann had two chances. With such a skill, he should have done something with at least one of them." The Spanish television filmed the moment when Griezmann went to the bench. Koeman didn't shake hands with a striker. Also, journalists noted that the partners continue to ignore the Frenchman and don't actually involve him in the game. Friends, do you think that perhaps Griezmann isn't suitable for Barcelona and he should say goodbye to the club next summer? And finally, a hilarious moment from Sergio Ramos. The Spanish national team and Real Madrid captain cheers up the team in that way. "We would put Sergio a solid 10 for such a beautiful simulation." Friends, we invite you to check out how the son of Cristiano Ronaldo played against Manchester City and how really good he is. The video is in front of you. Enjoy watching! Well, we will say goodbye for now. It was Football News. Bye-bye!